going to show you how easy it is to make caramel at home. And it is very easy. I know a lot of you do know how to make it, but there are some critical points to remember when making it so it doesn't burn or crystallize. Now, when I'm making my caramel at home, particularly when I'm making dry caramel, which will give you that really intense caramel flavor, I like to use caster sugar because it's got a high dissolving crystal, meaning it's perfect to make that beautiful, glossy, amber-like coloured caramel. Now, in a dry pan, and you want to make sure it's dry and clean, we'll add the caster sugar. Now, there are two ways of making caramel. You could add a little bit of water, which means it's just a little bit more easier to control, but you won't get that intense flavour. So don't add any water, and then turn the heat on to a medium heat. Now, in order for this caramel to work perfectly every time, make sure you don't agitate the pan too much. So you can start by moving it a little bit, but then just let it do its thing and you'll start to see a few little hot spots where the sugar starts to dissolve. Now, I like to have a little pastry brush and some water on standby, because if you see some of the sugar crystallizing along the sides of the pan, then all you need to do is just brush it down to ensure that it doesn't crystallize. By crystallizing, it means that we won't get that beautiful golden colored caramel that we're looking for. So now all we need to do is keep an eye on it. Don't go and make a cup of tea. Watch it, because it can turn very easily. Now, the temperature that we're looking for when it comes to caramel is roughly around 160 degrees. If it gets to 180 and over, it means it's going to start to burn. So if you like, you could use a thermometer to control the sugar. So I'm going to keep an eye on it and we'll wait for it to turn that gorgeous golden colour. As you can see, the colour has completely changed and now it's that amber colour. It's ready to go. It smells like toffee. I love it. It can really turn quite fast now, so take it off the heat. And if you want to use it immediately, if you're making a creme caramel, then place this pan in a bowl of cold, icy water. That'll hold the cooking process straight away. Now, you can use this to make almond brittle. Like I said, you could use it with creme caramel. There are so many different options when you're making a caramel. This, for me, is liquid gold. But don't forget, it's super hot, so be careful when making it. Thank you.